Hey guys, and welcome to Car Guy 1999 Reviews as well as Quirk Auto Dealers. Today we have something pretty special that a couple people have asked, and I've actually taught a couple people in person. This will be how to drive a manual transmission, more specifically starting out. This is really meant for a beginner or somebody who has a little bit of experience but wants to learn a bit more how to be a bit smoother. We'll be featuring the 2021 Forte GT. This one comes with a manual transmission. You can get a DSG, but of course this is about learning how to drive manual. So depending on if you've ever driven manual before, had some experience, I'll start with the basics. As you'll see, you have three pedals down here. Your clutch, brake, and gas. Your right foot should always modulate between gas and brake. So in that aspect, it's the same as an automatic. Your left foot now modulates from this dead pedal to use the clutch. Now, where most people screw up for setting off in a manual is releasing this clutch too quickly. So they'll have their foot down and they'll be like, all right, slowly. That is too fast. Basically, you'll find in each clutch, there'll be a certain point where it starts to engage. In this car, it's about midway. So right about here, you want to start being really, really slow. You'll feel the car move forward, or you'll watch the RPMs drop, and then you just want to be really, really slow. And then right about here, you'll feel it will basically be moving under its own power. Then you can release the clutch. When you're shifting, or when you come to a stop, I should say, you don't have to be smooth with the clutch. You can just push it right in with your foot. When you're changing gears, you can push the clutch. Whenever you push the clutch in, it can be as fast as you want. So when you go to shift, push the clutch in, and then just a little bit slower to release the clutch. Let's hop inside. Here's your gear shift, of course. Whenever I like to start my cars in neutral. It's just easier for me in case, you know, if I'm in first, I start the car and I take my foot off the clutch, it's not gonna move forward. I'm gonna go ahead and shut the door. You'll also notice when you park a manual, you have to use the e-brake. This one has your traditional e-brake. You might find a button down here, might find a button over here, might be a foot brake. They're all different. Every car is different. To start, like I said, a lot of people leave it in gear when it's off, just in case the parking brake fails. So go ahead, put it in neutral. Shift. Wiggle the shifter back and forth. If it moves around, you are in neutral. Whereas now I'm in third, you can't move it around as much as neutral. Basic shifter actions. 9 times out of 10, there's some very, very rare cars that this is not the case. First gear is going to be towards you and up. Right-hand drive cars, it's away from you and up. Second gear is going to be straight down. I like to kind of keep pushing left when I shift. Third gear, you just kind of put it into neutral and then up. Fourth gear is just straight back down. Fifth, I go to neutral all the way right and up. And then while pushing right, straight down into sixth. For reverse, each car is a little bit different. It's always stated on the shifter. You're going to lift up all the way over towards you and up. Now starting the car, relatively simple. You're gonna, like I said, put it in neutral, put your foot all the way down on the clutch, foot on the brake, and then push the start button. And now it's started. When you're in neutral, you can just get your foot off the clutch. And you can just sit here idling. Now here comes the fun part. we're on a little bit of a downhill slope. So keep in mind, I'm gonna start rolling back a little bit, but it's perfectly fine. So what I like to tell people is to practice using the clutch. Before you even put it in gear, just practice being nice and slow. It should take a solid 5 seconds for you to disengage the clutch when you're just starting out. So you wanna go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, off. You know, that's a good frame of mind. That shows you how slow you should really be. Of course, once you get used to the car, you can start speeding up that process. I'm gonna move the steering wheel so you can see the gauges a bit more. Now, foot on the clutch at all times when moving the shifter into first, putting the e-brake down. As I said, I'm gonna start rolling back. But what you wanna do is slowly release that clutch until you get to the engagement point. So sometimes what I like to do is have my foot on the brake, start releasing the clutch, once I feel it start to jerk, that's the engagement point. So you'll see, car was close to stalling, but slowly you'll feel the car want to start move forward. But that's where you know that's your engagement point. That's where you have to be slowest. A lot of cars now have anti-stall, so you can start slowly releasing the clutch. Right here, the car's starting to move forward. I'm just keeping my foot there, ever so slowly releasing, ever so slowly bringing it towards me. And now we're moving. I have my foot off the clutch and the car is moving under its own power. This is where you want to just barely give it a little bit of gas and you are moving. Coming to a stop, foot quickly on the clutch and use the brake as normal. Getting started again, off the brake, slowly releasing the clutch. I'm not moving my foot. I mean, I am barely bringing it up. And you're moving. So you want to just keep practicing that motion where you're stopped, your foot off the brake, no gas, and just slowly releasing that clutch. When you're on a hill, you'll start to feel the car stop rolling backwards. That's when you know you're at the engagement point. Most cars, by the time you reach 5 miles an hour, you're okay to release the clutch a little bit quicker. The car's moving under its own power. Foot on the clutch and brake. Now we're going to be going downhill, so it's even easier. Foot off the brake. So this basically, as soon as you start releasing your foot, you'll feel the car start to move when it's at its engagement point. And then nice and smooth. I'll bring the camera down to my feet. And now we're moving forward. And you can drive around in first, kind of get used to the car, kind of get used to the feel. And then just kind of drive around in first. Now, what if you have an older car that doesn't have auto stall feature? Well, this is where this technique comes in handy, and this is what I use whenever I'm in an unfamiliar car. First, you want to start off by practicing rev control. So what I like to do is rev the motor to 1500 RPM. It takes a very sensitive foot to get it just right. And there we go, we're at 1500 RPM. Let off the throttle. Do that again. Get used to that. Get used to that motion and how much throttle you need to keep it there. Now, This makes it a little bit easier to not stall if you're too quick with the clutch, but also you can burn up the clutch if you're not careful. So this is why I tell people always to practice bringing it up to 1500, not above, just bring it to 1500, keep it there, and then back. Because what this technique does, you're gonna keep it at 1500 RPM, and then even as you're starting to release the clutch, you're gonna keep it there. If the revs start to drop, give it a little bit more gas. And if it rises above, let off the gas a little bit. I always tell people start out with not using the gas. It gets you used to the clutch and how slow you actually need to be. This is the next step. So, same as before, first gear, foot on clutch and brake. Off the brake, and I'm gonna rev it to 1500 and slowly release the clutch. See, it's starting to drop. I'm giving it a little bit more gas. And you're moving. Practice this again. At a stop, 1500, releasing the clutch. A little bit more gas, and you're moving. Last time, 1500. No, I didn't get it right. Little bit of gas, and there you go. Now I'm gonna turn around and talk about shifting into the next gear. It's, as everyone knows, driving manual, the hardest part is getting moving. Once you're moving, it's like driving a normal car, except when it comes time to shift. So we're gonna barely give it any gas. Now we're moving again. Now when it comes time to shift, put your hand on the shifter, foot in on the clutch quick, down, nice and slow on the clutch, and that's second gear. I'll go ahead, I'll demonstrate again. Whenever you come to a stop, you always put the clutch in. If you don't, actually, you know what? I'll demonstrate it right now. If you don't put the clutch in and just hit the brake, the car stalls. Likewise, if you're too quick with the clutch, it's gonna stall. So it's all about finding a balance. 1500, slowly. There we go. Come time to shift, foot on clutch, down to second, slowly releasing the clutch, and gas. Same thing with the next gear, foot in, up to third, and down. And off the clutch. And now I'm on the clutch for turning around. Foot quick. So that's the basic gist of everything. And then for downshifting, it's relatively the same. As a beginner, I like to just come to a stop in neutral or with my foot on the clutch. I'm gonna make a part two with a bit more advanced techniques with how to drive manual, but this is how to get started. This is what you should be doing. Find an empty road, find an empty parking lot. The key is practice. It took me like 2 or 3 days to learn how to not stall, but it took me 2 or 3 years to be perfectly smooth with it. And even today, I'm not extremely smooth and I make mistakes. It's gonna take a while to learn. But you'll notice the more you do it, it's like riding a bike. It's gonna come back to you. You're gonna get smoother and smoother and smoother. So as a quick recap, when you're starting out, don't use the gas, just release the clutch as slow as you can at the engagement point. Find the engagement point on your car, whatever car you're learning on, and then be extremely slow. Some clutches even when you're releasing, you'll feel it start to push against your foot. It gets heavier at the engagement point. That's good. You know that's where you need to be the slowest. Setting off with the beginner technique first, slowly releasing the clutch. I'm at the engagement point. I stop my foot, and now I am like just lifting my toe. And then once it's moving like 5 miles an hour, you can lift off the clutch. The second technique is a little bit more complicated, especially if you're on a hill, but you rev it to 1500 and do the same thing and keep it at 1500 until you're moving, and then you go. When it comes time to shift, push the clutch in quick, off the gas, down towards second, and slowly release the clutch. As you do this more, you will get more and more confident and be more and more successful. Do not get discouraged if you stall or if you buck the car around. You will not hurt the car. I promise you that. The only way you'll hurt the car is if you burn the clutch by revving it to 6,000 RPM and releasing the clutch like that. Use these techniques that I taught you. This is how I taught myself. My father gave me these techniques, and then I kind of adapted them to teach. I've taught 5-6 people in person how to drive manual, and they pick it up quite quickly just by using these techniques. Thank you guys so much for watching. Please like, share, and subscribe. I'll see you all in the next one.